Hello and welcome to Speaking of Lake Ridge New Tech Schools. Speaking of Lake Ridge New Tech Schools is a public affairs program sponsored by the school district. Our goal here at Speaking of Lake Ridge New Tech Schools is to discuss issues in education that affect our schools, students, and community. In addition, we will do our best to provide you with answers to some of the pertinent questions of the day. Through our dialogue, we hope to introduce you to our faculty and staff and to other professionals involved in shaping your child's future. Our mission statement is transforming education, inspiring lives, and empowering all. I'm your host, Eric Johnson, and our guests today are from Purdue University Northwest. They are Christina Maldonado and Yanira Yanni Diaz. Welcome, ladies. Glad to have you here.
Thank you for having us.
And it's always nice to talk to Boilermakers. And so you all are with, a couple of programs, and one of them is really near and dear to my heart because it's such an awesome program. I'm talking about the 21st Century Scholars Program. You all oversee that and TRIO. I'm not as familiar with TRIO, but you're going to explain that to us as well. And so let's jump right in and talk about, first tell us a little bit about yourselves. What do you do, Christina, over at Purdue Northwest?
So I'm the Parent Community and Early Education Liaison at Purdue University Northwest. I work out of the Office of Undergraduate Admissions, and a large part of my role includes community outreach and working with students in grades K through 12, in which I do classroom presentations about college and careers, talk to students about their future options, and also host campus visits for elementary and middle school students on our campuses at Hammond and on Westville campus as well.
Mm-hmm. And what about you, Yanni? What do you do?
So I'm the program coordinator for TRIO Talent Search. And what TRIO Talent Search is, it's a pre-college program that works with students starting in sixth grade all the way to 12th grade of high school. And our goal is to make sure that the student stays on track, knows their option, whether it's going to a four-year university, going to college, or trade school, to make sure that they're prepared. So we offer different kinds of services, from tutoring, ACT, ACT boot camps, from one-on-one career and financial counseling, from exposing them to visiting different colleges, not only in Indiana, but outside of Indiana. And also exposing our students to the STEM fields by taking them to different cultural activities. Everything we do is completely free. It's covered from the program, from admission tickets to providing lunch, meals, snacks, to the transportation of our students.
You know, it sounds to me like what you ladies do, it's extremely important because a lot of times in our community of the region, Northwest Indiana, you have some students who are first generation college students, and you know they need that type of exposure to universities and to kind of find out the behind the scenes mechanisms as to how do you enroll and what classes do you take. And do you agree with that?
Yes. I 100% agree with that. Purdue Northwest is actually a university that's a first-gen forward university. We're very proud of that. We have about 56% of our student population that are first-generation students. Ms. Diaz and myself are first-generation students as well. So this is sort of a work of passion for both of us that we are both very passionate about informing students about all of the opportunities and programs and resources available to them to help them achieve their post-secondary goals.
And it also sounds like, because you start at as early as elementary school, it sounds like parents and students should begin thinking about college. I mean, it used to be, I'm a sophomore in high school, I think I'll go to college. But now it seems like they should probably start thinking about it as early as elementary school. Is that true?
Yes, true. We feel the earlier the better. That way the student has a more understanding. And also the parents, we want to create a support system for the students to make sure that, hey, we have your back.
We're here in case you have any questions. So the earlier they start, I think they get more of like a rounded experience of what it would be like to go to college. Mm-hmm.
And so now let's start out talking about TRIO, because I'm not familiar with it. Please explain it to us.
Oh, yeah. So TRIO, it's federally funded. That's why we're able to cover 100% of all of our activities towards our participants. And how do you join? How do we get started with TRIO? We have been going to these schools, Lake Ridge Middle School, as well as the high school, Calumet New Tech. And we do classroom presentations, go around just giving out the information to the students. We're at open houses, report card pickup days. We have an informational table. So if you're ever interested, you could go down to the counselor's office and they have our TRIO applications there. You fill it out, you hear back within a couple of weeks. Currently, we do have a wait list, so we are booming. We have a lot of activities, so our program has really grown. Mm-hmm. We're hoping that by the fall, we will be able to start taking on new students. So if you do want to get your application in, now early to have a safe spot for the fall. And when you start with the program, depending on your grade level, we're going to put a curriculum, you know, depending on where you're at. So definitely like our freshmen and our sophomores, we're going to focus a lot on college visitations, ACT preparations, searching scholarships, writing essays, financial literacy, mm-hmm. you know, versus the middle school students where we will start taking them on day trips to visit universities that are local. We will start taking them to STEM activities to just give them that behind the scenes of what a STEM career would look like. We have career workshops on campus, goal setting workshops, and everything is geared towards their grade level so they could understand it better. And definitely once they're seniors in high school, we sit down with them, do their financial aid, do their college applications. They necessarily don't have to go to Purdue, but if you do, I'm here for you 100%. But our mission is to expose the student to different universities, colleges, or trade schools.
And you said it's interesting that you would say trade mm-hmm. schools because a lot of people think it's college or nothing else. But a good trade school mm-hmm. Can get you a great start yes. in life too, can't it?
Yes. Yes. So we make sure that our mission, both of us, when we're in classrooms talking to students, we're not quote-unquote recruiters in the sense that we're telling all students, please come to Purdue Northwest. Obviously, we'd be very happy to have them, but we understand that every student is going to need to find something that is the correct fit for them. And if that's trade school, then we want to help them navigate their path into finding the correct trade school and seeking the correct career path for them. And we do think this all needs to begin much earlier than high school. For so long, the focus has been on high school to prepare for post-secondary, but we're realizing that that's too late in the game. And so we do want to start in the elementary schools and strengthen that in the middle school so that they are prepared in high school for the rigor that they will experience and then for their post-secondary options as well.
And now, you know, when you talk about, you know, elementary school and getting students interested in going to college and choosing a college major, what is the, you know, let's say a child is just, I'm really good in math. Is that child, you know, they say, hey, maybe you want to consider a career in business, or maybe you want to consider a career in the sciences or in the technology field. Me, I was terrible in math, but I like to read and I like to write. So I wound up doing this. I mean, so you know, how do you guide a young person who, you know, because when you're in fourth or fifth grade, you know, everything seems like, wow, that's a million years from now. But that million years goes by pretty fast.
Yes.
And so, you know, how do you, when do you start talking to kids about choosing a career?
So at the elementary level, we basically talk to them about there are many options and ask them what they're thinking they would like to do when they grow up at that point. And when you're in first grade or second grade, you probably name off 5 different jobs that you want to have when you grow up. And we hear that a lot with our kindergartners and first graders. They have so many choices that they want, which is awesome. And we always make sure to let them know that it's okay to change your mind over and over. Mm-hmm. We use our own personal examples and of our career paths and how we've changed our mind to come and arrive at our current positions and career paths. But we also want to make sure they know that leadership skills are important along the way. Mm-hmm. And so we want to build their confidence and help them acquire leadership skills and tell them things like, if there's not a club at school that you are interested in, you can start your own club. And this is how you can start your own club in school, and kind of give them this confidence in themselves, because that's going to need to be built upon as they go through middle school and especially in high school, so that they can narrow down their career path that they choose. Mm-hmm. And then have a much better idea in high school as to what that's going to be.
And so it does really start as early as elementary school.
Yes.
And then do you find that elementary school students, you know, because they're still new in the education process, that they're more open to exploring different curriculums and different fields?
Yes, I feel they get so amazed and happy with all the different opportunities that are offered to them. Mm-hmm. And I love that they're ready to learn. Whether you feel like, oh, but my child, all they want to do is stay inside and play video games. And then that's when we're like, oh, you're interested in video games. Awesome. So you know that, you know, there's this different career paths that you could choose, where you get to play video games for, you know, for fun, for money, to have a career. Mm-hmm. So we take what the students, you know, is interested in, and then we work with that. So I feel like the younger they are, we're able to kind of see, you know, what interests them, what they don't like, and then take from that to help them grow.
Mm-hmm. In case you're just tuning in, you are listening to Speaking of Lake Ridge New Tech Schools. I'm your host, Eric Johnson, and we are very fortunate to have in our studio today Christina Maldonado and Yanira Yanni Diaz. They're from Purdue University Northwest, and they work with young people in giving them ideas and solutions to prepare themselves for life after high school. And one of the main things that I know that you all work with is a program that's been around for a long time. And it does not receive, I think, I'm not going to say the attention, but maybe it's a little bit misunderstood. And I'm talking about the 21st Century Scholars Program. That is a program that you can sign your child up in their 8th grade year from the day one until now, I guess, is the end of June. But you can sign them up and then they take a pledge. Well, we're going to let them explain it. What exactly is the 21st Century Scholars Program?
So the 21st Century Scholars Program is a program designed from the state of Indiana back in 1990 that is a scholarship program for eligible Indiana students to pay up to 100% of a 2-year or 4-year degree post-secondarily in a Indiana-accredited college, university, or trade school. Students who are eligible would need to be a citizen of the United States or have a specified visa status. If not a citizen, they need
So if the parent is not a citizen, but the child is, still eligible?
Still eligible, yes.
Okay.
Yes. They need to be an Indiana resident. They need to attend an accredited Indiana middle school in 7th or 8th grade. And then they need to be a member of a family that qualifies under the income eligibility guidelines that are provided for the scholarship as well.
Now, this is one of those things. So if the parents sign them up, they take the pledge. The pledge consists of what throughout high school?
So the pledge is actually for the student. And the student is sort of promising to fulfill these requirements and maintain these things as a scholar so that they do not lose their scholarship. The scholar pledge basically includes them completing the scholar success program, which is three activities that they're required to complete, three each year of high school, which totals 12 by the end of their high school career. They must stay on track by maintaining a 2.5 GPA out of a 4.0 scale. They have to graduate with a Core 40 honors diploma at the very minimum and agree to not use drugs, commit a crime or a delinquent act, or consume alcohol before reaching the age of 21. They must file their FAFSA when they're a high school senior and then every year after that while in college. And then agree to maintain the satisfactory academic progress as established by their institution of higher education, and complete 30 credit hours as well every year while they're in college to maintain, to make sure they're staying on track toward their degree in a timely manner.
Mm-hmm. So that, to me, is not asking too much to keep a C-plus average in high school, and then you'll get college scholarship dollars, almost your entire college paid for, which can save your parents thousands of dollars. But for some reason, we have a lot of parents who are reluctant to sign the paper. Tell me, why are parents reluctant to do so, and why should they, you know, feel that way?
So in our experience, we've seen that there are a number of schools, especially in Northwest Indiana, where the free and reduced lunch population is well over 50% of their student population. However, that doesn't translate into the number of students enrolled as 21st century scholars. So a lot of what Ms. Diaz and I have been doing is trying to debunk whatever myths are out there as to why these families
aren't. Myth number one, I'm not letting the government know everything that I'm doing.
Yes. Yes. So there is this lack of trust in the program and this idea that perhaps it's a scam and that it's not a legitimate program. Mm-hmm. So we've been working really hard to make sure they know there's 45,000 students in the state of Indiana that have gone through this and earned their degrees as 21st century scholars. And then, as was mentioned previously, the Social Security number that is required on the application is also a point of reluctance for a lot of families. Ourselves included, we're always reluctant to give out that number. And on the paper application, we receive so many of them that we need to return back to the school counselors because mm-hmm. that's the one item that's always missing. So we think those are two huge mm-hmm. things that are...
So how do you assure parents that it's okay to fill all of that out?
Well, I feel we've been doing it long enough that hopefully, you know, they've learned to trust us. But mm-hmm. we want to communicate with the parents, first of all. We're trust, you know, this is our job. So we want to make sure that your student is going to get the scholarship. So when you fill out the information, we take it, we put it into the system ourselves, and the form gets locked up. Mm-hmm. We lock it up for a reason because it has all your important information, but also we keep a paper format for future issues. If they arrive, we want to make sure that we have a backup that you did turn in that application. So it's a lot of talking with the parent. We're here to talk to you. We have, when it's open houses, we have a booth set up to make sure that you understand that our mission is to just make sure that your student does not lose out on $45,000. Mm-hmm. You know, you giving us your information, we have nothing to do with that. We just simply take that information and we transfer it over to the state's online database so your student could now be an approved 21st century scholar student.
Mm-hmm. I think that the other barrier is maybe technology as well, mm-hmm. because if a family isn't given a paper application, they need to go online and register themselves.
And you can do that.
Yes. You can register online for your student. But we do have a lot of families, a lot of students who are being raised by grandparents as well that are not technologically savvy and they're not mm-hmm. Capable of navigating the entire scholar track system and enrolling their own students. So that might pose a barrier as well in some situations.
Mm-hmm. You know, and you know what is a very sad fact is that you have kids that, you know, they graduate from middle school and they go to high school And they do all the right things. They make good grades. They 2.5 grade point average and higher. And then at the end of their 4 years, you know, graduation has come. It seems like it comes faster and faster every year. But they graduate and then they go to apply. And Indiana certainly has some of the top schools in the United States. We have some of the top colleges and universities, some of the top trade schools. Indiana is very fortunate to have these schools all around the area. You don't even have to leave home. You can go to a Purdue Northwest. You can go to an IUN. You can go to a Valparaiso. These are schools that are top schools that are right here, let alone going down to Bloomington or down to, you know, West Lafayette or down to Muncie or Terre Haute. So the kids do all the right things that they're supposed to do, and then, you know, and they do fall under the economic purview of being, you know, getting the 21st century scholars. Then they find out, hey, my parents didn't sign me up. Now they're stuck maybe having to get loans or maybe trying to have to you know, work and put themselves through school when it could have all been avoided just by signing the paper. Do you run into many cases like that?
Oh, yes, all the time. Sophomores in high school, seniors in high school. It's like, what can I do? Can I still sign up? And it's so heartbreaking when we have to tell them, well, you're supposed to have signed up in 7th and 8th grade. And it's devastating for us because so many students are missing out on this one opportunity. It's a huge opportunity the state is giving your student. It takes less than 5 minutes to fill out. Less than 5 minutes. A lot of the information is basic information where the student could actually start filling out. And so our job, our mission has been to inform as many parents and students out there to know about this program, because you're leaving money behind on the desk. You're leaving $45,000, and those $45,000 would just open up doors for your student.
Absolutely. And they've expanded the program because originally it was just 8th grade, but now you're saying 7th graders can sign up?
As early as 7th graders, yes.
And we also make sure we tell 7th and 8th graders when we're in classrooms, like, we hear a lot that, well, we don't think we're going to go to college. And so Ms. Diaz and I make sure we tell them, well, maybe you think that right now, but it's still important that you enroll in this program because you have plenty of time to think about it, and at least this will be an option for you if you decide to pursue college or a trade school, as opposed to you'll have to pay for it out of your own pocket at that point if you do change your mind and decide you are going to choose a post-secondary option.
And that is a really good point that you just made, because you do hear that. So I hate school. I'm never going to go. When I graduate, I'm done with school. But you don't know.
Right.
And so it is good just to sign up. And so let's say if I have, five kids, okay, can I sign up all five of my kids? Let's say I have five in, you know, two in 7th grade and three. And, you know, you could have a set of twins. I mean, you could have.
Yes.
You know, are all your kids eligible?
Yes, they are. Yes, they are. Yes.
As long as you meet the income guidelines.
Yes. I currently have a family of 7, and all her 7 children have gone through this program. 3 of them are already graduates of college, and the last 2 are 21st century scholars. So it's
all of them. You should get a testimonial from that parent, because I'm sure the parents who do sign up and their kids do go off to college and graduate, I'm sure those parents are, you know, very proud of their children and probably can, you know, say, hey, do it, sign up.
If I could get her on here, she will tell you, I am zeroed up my children all without any loans, because 21st century scholars put them through college.
You know, and that is a great thing. I don't know if every state, I'm sure probably states have similar programs, but I do know about Indiana, and I think that that is one of the best programs in the state. And, you know, and we don't want it to be one of the best kept secrets, and that's why we, right. you know, and So tell people how they can get in contact with you that are listening to this program right now. They may say, you know, I've heard about it, but, you know, now I want to find out more.
Yes, you can get in contact with me. My phone number is 219-989-2708.
And that's Christina.
Christina Maldonado. Christina Maldonado, yes. Mm-hmm. You can also reach me via email at maldon at Purdue. I'm sorry, at pnw.edu. I'll say that again. maldon55 at pnw.edu.
And Yanira Diaz, how can they reach you?
And my phone number is 219-989-2774. My email is the letter YDIAZ at pnw.edu. That's YDIAZ at pnw.edu.
And the TRIO program, which you oversee,
yes.
What's going? Are you all doing anything over the summer with school?
Oh, my gosh. Yes, just tomorrow we're going to Detroit for an excursion.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Can I go?
We're taking our high school students out there to explore some of the college's museums as well.
Wow.
We're going by the Canadian border to just kind of, you know, see what's around. And on Tuesday, we're taking our middle school students to a STEM activity where they're going to do an accelerated indoor race carts, driving races, and learn about, you know, the dynamics of how to build a race car. And we have tons of summer camps in partnership with Purdue University Northwest, ranging from innovative, if you want to do entrepreneurship or learning about STEM, 3D printing, robotics, a bunch of different camps for different levels of your students' age group.
It sounds to me like TRIO is really a good program to get your child involved in, because they can then begin to explore different career paths, different college majors, and see how things beyond Northwest Indiana and how they can get involved. So how can a child get involved in TRIO?
So right now we have applications at the Lake Ridge Middle School, which is one of our target schools. So all students at Lake Ridge who are listening right now, and parents, your student automatically qualifies for our program, as well as the high school, the Calumet New Tech High School, you qualify. We also have spots open for sixth graders in the area as well. There's applications at the counseling center. You just pick up an application, fill it out, return it right back to the counselor. I pick it up myself, or our director comes around and picks it up. Really simple demographic information. We don't need essays. I don't need, you know, a lot of information about you. Our main contact is via phone and email. So that's very important when we send out information, for you to have a valid email, because you could miss out on trips. And if you also want to look us up online, you could look up, we have our online website set up and under Purdue, so pnw.edu. On the search bar, look up TRIO ETS, and you will find more information about us and also how to apply online.
Once again, I got five kids. Can all five sign up for TRIO?
Yes, yes, all of them. And I love when we get siblings, because it's like a two for one. So when we go on a trip, you know, my brother wants to come too. Great.
Yeah.
Yes.
That is fantastic. And so, listeners out there, if you are in that situation where you would like to sign your children up for these fantastic programs, the 21st Century Scholar Program or TRIO, or if you know of someone, if your grandchildren or nieces and nephews, have them get in contact with Ms. Maldonado and Ms. Diaz over at Purdue Northwest, so they can get signed up. And all the schools in the state have that information also at their school. So if I'm a parent or grandparent, all I have to do is say, go up to Lake Ridge Middle School and ask for the information, and they should have it?
Yes, correct. You just say, I'm here to pick up TRIO and 21st century information, and the counselors, the administration up front desk will be able to hand you over applications.
That is just some wonderful, awesome news. Now, I've heard that, is it next year or the year after, that all 7th and 8th graders will be a part of the 21st Century Scholars Program? So does that mean they don't have to sign their children up this year, or is this the last year that they do?
So Indiana recently passed legislation which will simplify the enrollment process for our 7th and 8th graders to be enrolled in the 21st Century Scholar Program. And from the updates that I have received, this should take place with this year's cohort of 7th and 8th graders. So the classes respectively of 2027 and 2028, mm-hmm. I believe. So that moving forward, this year's 8th grade class and those that should follow would no longer need to go through the process of the online or the paper application. They'll be automatically enrolled.
So would you suggest, though, that they do check to do it, or that's etched in stone now?
So currently what I was told was to continue enrollment as normal. So we are continuing with what we've been doing with paper applications and helping others enroll on the computer as well. Until we receive further information about new updated processes, we're going to continue as we have been. And then once we get word from the state about the new processes in place, then we'll shift over to those.
Oh, okay. Because this year's 8th grade cohort, you still have time to sign up.
Correct.
What is that deadline date?
June 30th.
June 30th. So yes. you got a couple of weeks left. So parents, if your child is graduated from 8th grade this year and you're interested in them becoming a 21st Century Scholar, all you have to do is go up to your child's middle school. In our case, it would be Lake Ridge Middle School. Mm-hmm. Tell them you want the form, fill the form out, and then what do you do with the form?
Ms. Diaz and I, one of us, will come collect the form, and we will manually enter it ourselves, and they will be enrolled as fast as that.
Wow, that's fantastic. And so this ostensibly could be the last year that you might have to do that, but do it.
Yes, please.
And so the current, the next year's 7th and 8th graders may not have to do it, but right now, make sure that you go up and you sign your kids up to be 21st Century Scholars if you have not done so yet.
Exactly.
And boy, I tell you, this time really did go by fast, but our time is up. We've been talking to Christina Maldonado and Yanira Diaz, and they are with Purdue University Northwest. Your prospective job titles are?
Parent, Community, and Early Education Liaison.
And that was Christina?
Yes.
Program Coordinator for TRIO Talent Search.
And that was Yanni Diaz. So parents, do take advantage of this, because as they just said, with the 21st Century Scholars, $45,000, just think, that's $45,000 that you don't have to pay for your child's college. That's $45,000 that stays in your pocket. and who could not use an extra $45,000 in their pocket? So make sure that you sign your children up. Grandparents, aunts, uncles, whoever, if you talk to the parents, tell them, hey, this is a great program. Sign your child up. Sign my grandchild up. Sign my niece or my nephew up. Because they're going to go to college, they're going to want to go to college, and this is the start of a great career. And it really opens up the door to college for, all sorts of people. Mm-hmm. Everybody has that opportunity, because as we all know, a college degree, a good trade, it changes your life. And so these are those opportunities. Well, ladies, thank you very much, and you have promised that you're going to be back, right?
We will be back.
We will be back.
And
for
so,
sure.
so that we will, because every time, I guarantee you, every time they come, they're going to have good news for students, and so we look forward to them coming back. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me.
And also, don't forget to listen to The Scoop with Linda Hobuck. That is the Spanish version. And I'm Eric Johnson. You've been listening to Speaking of Lake Ridge New Tech Schools. Speaking of Lake Ridge New Tech Schools is a public affairs program sponsored by the school district. Let us know how you feel. Contact the schools and give us some suggestions on what programming you would like to hear. Thank you very much, ladies. Have a great day.
Thank you.